Thank you. Good evening. I'd ask that you all please rise as we are led in the Pledge of Allegiance by those graduates that will be entering the armed forces.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Now please join our senior choir in the singing of the national anthem. Please be seated. As we come together this evening to celebrate the accomplishments of the class of 2023, we also remember all those who are not with us this evening, those whose presence has helped shape us and been a significant part of our lives. Especially when we reach important life milestones, we remember all of those who have had a positive effect on who we have become. As the principal of Fayetteville Manlius High School, I am pleased to welcome you, the families and guests of the class of 2023, to our commencement ceremony. We come together tonight to honor the members of Fayetteville Manlius High School Class of 2023 to celebrate their successful completion of the course of study prescribed by the state of New York for a high school diploma. They are ready to begin the next chapter of their lives, so let us begin. At this time, I'd like to invite Class President Victoria Cavallini to the podium to address her classmates.
Good evening, friends, faculty, and family members, my fellow graduates. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Victoria Cavallini, and I've been our class president for the past 2 years. I'd like to get started off by thanking you all for being here and constantly supporting all of us through our time at FM, because none of us would be here today without all of you. I've been waiting for today since I first became president, not because I'm graduating or leaving FM, but because I hate public speaking more than anything on earth. Last spring, I was about 5 seconds away from quitting for the sole reason of getting out of doing this speech, but everyone called me stupid for that, so obviously here I am. My sister Talia is somewhere up there knowing this whole speech because I actually made her write everything up to this point for me. And my mom also knows this word for word because she made me read it to her maybe like 100 times and wrote me like 5 entire speeches as options because she had no faith in my speechwriting abilities. You should all be grateful I'm not using one of those though, because she really pulled out her inner preschool teacher in her writing and wanted me to give you all this little quote from Dr. Seuss. Don't cry because it's over, smile because it happened. And while it's very true and hits hard, especially today, I thought it would make more sense to quote someone who's made more of an impact in all of our childhoods. And that man is Mr. Worldwide. As the one and only Pitbull said, this is for everybody going through tough times. Believe me, been there, done that. But every day above ground is a great day, remember that. I know that sounds cliche and everyone uses it in their speeches, but if you really think about it, it's so true. High school is a time in our lives where we're supposed to figure everything out about ourselves, choose what we want to do and who we want to be for the rest of our lives. We all complain about classwork and having to wake up early every single day. I know me personally, at least, I would dread getting out of bed in the morning and I would count down the seconds until I could go back home and sleep. But this Tuesday, all I could think about was how I'm never going to be there again. I wasn't dreading being there, I was dreading having to leave. Every 40 minutes when the bell would ring, I would think about never being able to go into Mrs. Du Bois's room to gossip, never going to steal candy from Mrs. Hans, and not seeing all the same people in the hallways that I've been with for the past 13 years of my life. Well, obviously 13, give or take a year or two, of course. I couldn't write a speech about our high school experience without including the fact that half of it was taken away from us. I vividly remember Link Crew Day in 2019 and being terrified of all the upperclassmen guiding us through the school. The one thing that all of them kept telling us was that high school flies by and we should appreciate every day that we have here and not to take any of it for granted. By March that year, I had decided that they were all delusional because those 6 months of freshman year felt more like 6 years. But then, surprise, surprise, the world shut down and we basically skipped ahead to junior year. In the blink of an eye, we became the upperclassmen that I had been so terrified of. So with our one full year of high school that we were given, I would definitely say that it flew by. In the past 10 months we've spent together, we've become exponentially closer and shoved what should have been 3 years of high school memories into 1 year. We finally won the battle of the classes that were 100% rigged against us freshman year because we deserved the win. The tug of war wasn't even a competition for us this year after almost winning as little freshmen, shout out Liam Algieri. We won the best student section in the 315, which no one's really surprised by because we showed our support at every game as soon as we were given the opportunity to. We had a successful senior ball with the mac and cheese bites that everyone was promised. Our MCs raised $120,000 all for the kids and so many other things. The list of memories we made this year goes on and on, but I wasn't given the time to go over everything that happened, so that was just a quick little rundown. The class of 2023 had the weirdest high school experience in history, but we persevered and made it work because that's just what we do. Even towards the end of our one normal year of high school, the world turned into a Zach Bryan song because everything was orange, but that's just really on brand for us. If we had a completely normal year of high school without any global pandemics or national weather catastrophes, I would have been shocked. So to all the seniors up here graduating with me, congratulations on getting through the most messed up but memory-filled 4 years of our lives. Everyone up here had to adapt to a completely new environment after entering high school to doing it online. So no matter where you're going after today, whether it's college, going to work, or just taking time off, everyone's gonna do great, and hopefully none of it is as our time spent at FM. So go out there, do whatever it is that you want to do, and if you put your mind to it and adapt to new environments, you will succeed. Congratulations, class of 2023.
Each year, the number one student in the graduating class has the honor of addressing their classmates during the graduation ceremony. I am pleased to invite Gene Ballion to the podium to address his classmates.
Congratulations.
Take your time. Deep breath, you're good.
Congratulations, graduates of the FM class of 2023.
Thank you. Thank you to our parents, families, and friends for being here and for your support. Thank you to the teachers, counselors, administrators, and staff for your encouragement and dedication. And thank you to my classmates for the memories we've had together. Our graduation walk at the elementary schools a couple days ago brought back some of the memories, memories that go back to our first few years of school, like my first grade class with Mrs. Meyer. It was so surreal to see Mrs. Meyer again with her own first grade class and think that 12 years ago, that was my class. Do you remember your elementary school morning pledge? At Fayetteville Elementary, we said, and feel free to join me if you remember, to make a better environment for everyone, I will be a problem solver, be caring, be responsible, be respectful, and be safe. At the time, I didn't reflect much on the meaning of these words, but now I realize that from the beginning, our teachers instilled the values of kindness and determination within us. That's why on the first day of high school, in Ms. Halloran's room, the two signs above the board in the center caught my eye. Be kind, one sign read, the other, try hard. Throughout our time at FM, many individuals have gone out of their way to create positive experiences that exemplify these two values of kindness and work ethic. I would like to honor just a few of these many amazing people. Mr. McGuigan, my economics teacher and tennis coach, has been a mentor and role model to me. Thank you for sharing your knowledge, wisdom, and sense of humor with me and the tennis team. Mr. McGuigan has truly made a difference in my life. Mr. Buckman amazes me with his showcases of magic and science, as well as his sincere compliments. Thank you for taking the time last year to write a postcard to me about my growth on the Masterminds team. The sense of wonder and the playful spirit that you bring to our physics class is inspiring. Thank you, Mr. Buckman. Ms. Hans's chemistry class was serious business, but we had fun sometimes, too. One day we had a snowball fight to learn about equilibrium, and at the end of the year, we squirted colored dye onto our class t-shirts. Mrs. Hans, thank you for the care you took in explaining chemistry to our class while instilling the values of integrity and kindness within us. Madame Woodward Jones provided a welcoming, warm space to learn French at Wellwood and at the high school, always greeting us by name as we entered the room. Dr. Mons touched me with her words and actions and her rich vegetable soup. Merci infiniment. Thanks a million to my French teachers. To our fantastic English teachers, Ms. Halloran, Ms. Newell, Mr. Clardy, to name a few, thank you for the life you always infused into our classes. Our math teachers, Ms. Hebert, Ms. Bishop, Mr. DeLands, Mr. Engel, are an integral part of our school. Indefinite integrals, to be sure. Thank you for reminding us to remember plus C. I was fortunate to learn the violin at FM with wonderful music teachers. Thank you to Ms. Thermo, Mrs. Darville, Mr. Guarino, and Mr. Mendez for your patience, passion, and expertise. We have one of the best music programs at FM with so many opportunities to perform. And thank you to Dr. Liparulo and the custodial staff for unlocking the doors on the countless times that I left my violin at school. Dr. Green created a welcoming and inclusive atmosphere that made my music theory class a delight every day. Walking into the classroom, greeted by the chords being played by Manny and Gilly at the keyboard, brought a cheerful glow to the center of my day. Dr. Green, thank you and congratulations on your retirement. One of the most enjoyable parts of my 4 years of high school was playing in the pit orchestra for the musical. First, at this moment, I would like to thank the pit orchestra for their performance of Pomp and Circumstance all 12 times? I don't know. I hope that your arms remain attached for the rest of the summer, but it took a lot of hard work, but the final productions for the musical were always amazing. Thank you to everyone who worked on Les Mis, A New World, SpongeBob, and The Little Mermaid. You all helped to make the art thrive in our FM community. Thank you to the participants and organizers of Dance Marathon and the other events that give back to our local community. This year, I was also proud to be part of the first Asian American Pacific Islander Month Assembly here at FM. It was great to share a greater portion of the diversity that we have at our school. Overall, thank you to all our teachers from FM, from kindergarten to 12th grade, for providing us with a wonderful education and space to grow. Every teacher has greatly impacted all of our lives. And thank you to our energetic and caring principal, Dr. Kilmer, for always being there for the class of 2023. Thank you to all of my friends and classmates. There are too many of you to name, but I would like to thank my table in French this year, May, Anna, Yulia, and Antonina, and our wellness break visitors, Wyatt, Evan, Elliot, and Zen, when he came, for making fifth period a memorable part of my day, and for our meaningful friendships over the years. To Lucy and Sarah, Darren and Elvis, Julia and Shrew, thank you all for brightening every day. And I am very excited to get into many pillow fights with Aiden in our dorm room in college this fall. Moving forward, we will all be heading our separate ways to separate places many miles apart. You will have worries about adjusting to your new life. Will I make new friends? Am I picking the right major? Am I on the right path? We are all uncertain about the future. When you feel like you are alone, know that you are always part of the FM community. There is always someone there who can help you get through a difficult time. We all need help and support to keep us moving forward. Lend your time to help others. Graduates, keep in touch with the teachers and adults you care about. Express your gratitude to others. It truly makes a difference. I would like to personally thank my family, my mom, my dad, my sister Karina, my aunt, my grandma and grandpa, my grandma who is in Taiwan, Uncle Ara and Aunt Laura, and all of my extended family for your love. Make sure to thank your family because you would not have made it here without them. And stay close with your family, even when you are apart. When you need direction, think of those words on Miss Halloran's wall. Be kind and try hard. Take a deep breath and relax, and know that it will be okay. No matter how basic they are, these words will carry us far. Congratulations, graduates, and enjoy the life ahead of you. Thank you.
Now this evening's musical selection, entitled Homeward Bound, will be performed by our senior choir members. It's now my pleasure to welcome Dr. Craig Tice, Superintendent of Fayetteville-Manlius School District, to the podium to offer some words and to introduce this year's commencement speaker.
On behalf of the Board of Education, the school administration, and the faculty and staff of the Fayetteville-Manlius Central School District, I congratulate all of our graduates on a job well done. Each and every year, it is my pleasure as the superintendent of schools to impart some profound advice and some sage wisdom to our graduates before I have the distinct honor of introducing the faculty speaker for this evening's commencement address. Because the COVID pandemic interrupted your freshman year, it would be very easy for me to craft my remarks to applaud your tenacity, adaptability, and perseverance in navigating the multiple years of disruption, all while juggling the expectations of remote, hybrid, and in-person learning models. Needless to say, the onslaught of the pandemic during your early years in high school brought forth considerable challenges and obstacles that all of you had to overcome in order to reach today's finish line. You should be proud of all that you've accomplished. The Fayetteville-Manlius Central School District vision statement states, "Our vision as a school community is to inspire students and to promote personal success." What does this mean exactly? It goes beyond the simple cause and effect relationship between these two concepts. Modern dictionaries would inform us that the word inspiration references the process of being mentally stimulated to do or feel something, especially to do something creative. Sources from Middle English, Old French, and Latin would suggest that the word inspiration was originally used to refer to the intervention of a spiritual, divine, or supernatural presence as it imparted a truth or an idea to someone. That being said, I hope that during your time at Fayetteville-Manlius that you have been inspired and mentally stimulated to do something creative, and that in doing so, you will have found your inner truth, your talents, your passions, and your interests. Why is this important? It's because if you've been inspired to pursue your talents, your passions, your dreams and interests, in all likelihood, you will be successful in achieving all your hopes and dreams. It embraces the cause and effect relationship that if you're inspired, you will become successful. All of us at Fayetteville-Manlius Central Schools remain committed to our vision statement, and we hope that in some small way over the years, we've encouraged you, challenged you, and supported you along the way so that you have been inspired and ultimately successful during your time at FM and in the future. With that said, it's now my distinct honor to introduce our faculty graduation keynote speaker, Ms. Megan DeBlois. A veteran high school mathematics teacher, Ms. DeBlois is a devoted mother of two girls. An avid golfer, Megan has won some major tournaments in the area in her limited spare time. Without a doubt, the students love spending time with Megan, and if you walk by her room during her planning period or after school, there are several students lingering around her desk just to talk with her. Without question, Megan supports students both in and out of the classroom. She attends many interscholastic events for her students and is often serving as a chaperone for dances, semi-formals, proms, and balls. Megan's closest colleague is Ms. Rachel Mason, where you can find one of them, you're usually able to find the other. Known for her ability to project her voice, you can often hear her down the hallway. In fact, Ms. DeBlois made her debut as a rapper during this year's Pi Day extravaganza. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ms. Megan DeBlois to deliver this year's commencement address.
Thank you, Dr. Tice. I want to begin by thanking the parents and the guardians of the graduates. Thank you for enrolling your children in the Fayetteville-Manlia School District. Thank you for entrusting my colleagues and me to educate, to mentor, and to love your children. I feel very fortunate to work in a school district with a community like this. Together, I think we raised a pretty amazing group of graduates. I am so, so, so proud of this group in front of me. I want to take a walk down memory lane for a moment. The class of 2023 entered the high school on September 10th, 2019 for Link Crew Day. None of us had any idea what the next 4 years had in store. Freshman year at Fayetteville-Manlius High School is supposed to be an exciting time when Eagle Hill and Wellwood combine to form new friendships. But unfortunately, the world shut down in March of 2020, and these freshmen would not finish their year in school. Then came September, sophomore year. Sometimes, I can't believe we actually got through that year. There were so many Google Meets. Were you cohort A, B, C? Many of you came to school just 2 days a week, logged onto the computer the other two, and who could forget the Wednesdays? Ah, such a nice time. Junior year was a tad more normal. Some activities resumed. It was really fun to see what people looked like when we took our masks off in April. And finally, fall of 2022, the start of senior year. The best one, in my opinion. Our lives were back to normal, and we were able to have all of our activities. Friday night football games, the fall play, the winter formal, the pink out basketball game, the DM assembly, the Black History Month assembly, the Little Mermaid, the Pi Day Assembly, Dance Marathon, the first ever Asian American Pacific Islander Assembly, Unified Bowling and Unified Basketball, Showboat, and lots of sporting events and clubs. Ball last Saturday, and today, graduation. What a wild ride it has been. Take a moment right now and let this all sink in. Despite 4 unconventional years of high school and the unique challenges that you faced, you did it. You are sitting at your high school graduation. This truly is a day of celebration for all that you have accomplished, a day to be proud of, and a day to remember forever. I've been teaching since 2006, and I have never felt a closeness like I do to this year's graduating class. I'd like to think of myself as a big sister, or maybe a cool aunt, but I've been affectionately nicknamed Mom. So before you move on to the next chapter of your life, I'd like to give you 5 pieces of mom advice. 1, show up. Go to class. Go to work. Don't skip. Don't call in sick, unless you really are. Employers want dependable people. Professors want students who are present. In 4 years at Nazareth College, I skipped 1 class. SU was in a Big East game. Who can blame me? College costs a couple of dollars. You're there to learn and to grow. When you hear that voice inside your head trying to decide if you should get up out of your cozy bed, get up. Ask my husband. No one enjoys their cozy bed more than me. But every day I hit the snooze button 3 or 4 times, and then I put my feet on the floor and I get up to be there for all of you. Whatever path you're taking next year, show up every day. And when you can, try to be early. 2. put your phone down, and take your earbuds out. This is the time to make new friends and new memories. Your high school friends are not going anywhere. You have a bond that no one can break, and a snap streak I know you wouldn't dare break. But there are so many people out there waiting to meet you. To put this in perspective, as I look out at all of you, I see so many faces of people that have become a big part of my life. I see students that I've taught, friends of the students that I've taught, friends of mine from my book club, friends of mine from playing golf, lots of my colleagues, and yet every single person that I see, I did not know when I was sitting at my high school graduation. There are hundreds, if not thousands, of people waiting to meet you. Reach out, smile, say hello, be kind, and step out of your comfort zone to meet new people. But to do that, you need to put your phone down and take your earbuds out. You never know when you will meet your future best friend, your soulmate, or your spouse. Number three, take care of yourself. Sleep when you're tired. Try to eat healthy meals, exercise, change your bed sheets. Find the balance between work and play. For 18 years, you've had someone watching over you and reminding you to do these things. It's now up to you to take care of yourself. Four, make time to talk to your family about your new adventure. Whether you're going off to college or pursuing a trade, they want to talk with you and they want to hear all about your life. A few minutes ago, I said that I didn't know anyone in here at my high school graduation. I lied. There are three people that I knew: my mom, my dad, and my sister. You see, it doesn't matter how old you are, your family is always going to be there to celebrate your big moments in your life. Stay in touch with them. They want to hear your voice. Call them on your walk to class. Call on your way to work. Call when you're procrastinating. Texting is great, but it will never replace a good old phone call. Five, finally, find something that you love to do. If you're unsure of what that is, take the time to figure it out. I was reading a book over spring break, and there was a line that stuck with me. You never work a day in your life when you do something that you love. This, not public speaking, teaching is what I was born to do. I genuinely love to teach high school math. I really love teaching the quadratic formula and the songs to help you remember it, but I'll spare you my many renditions. I enjoy all the topics except maybe sequences. But above all, I cherish the relationships with my students. I love when you come into my room and you tell me the word on the street. What do you call it? The T? I love when you visit me just to steal, not ask, steal a lollipop. I love when you choose to spend your senior privilege period with me. I love when you ask me to take your B-reel. I love when you come to borrow a calculator so your science teacher doesn't yell at you, or when you ask me to take your calculator out of test mode. I love when you ask me if I can go to your game or what night I plan on attending the musical. I love being there for you. My job is part math teacher, part counselor, part friend. This is the career for me, and I want all of you to find a career that you love just as much as I love teaching. Sorry. I'm gonna miss you all so much. But it's time to go and to make a difference in this world. Remember, the people that are here for you tonight will always be there to support you. I wish you lots of happiness. Go out there and change the world. Hornet Pride. Congratulations, class of 2023. I love you all.
You guys doing okay? A lot of people talking to you, I know. Is it okay if I say a couple things? You sure? Okay, you guys are great, thank you. So as principal, I always get the privilege of being the last speaker. But it's always a privilege to speak to you one last time. And so I just have a couple of thoughts to share with you. And I want to bring you back to Wednesday. I arrived at Enders Road just a few minutes before the buses arrived. As soon as the buses came into view, driving down Enders Road, there was an announcement over the PA system that the graduates were just moments away. You could immediately hear this buzz throughout the building. It was incredible. There was such excitement in the air in each of those elementary schools. Kindergartners to fourth graders raced into position, grabbing posters, pom-poms, teachers hurrying their students from classroom into the hallway, lining up to greet all of you. You pulled into campus, music started playing over the PA system, and there was just this surge of life in those spaces. You walked into a building that represented a time you had left just 8 years earlier. Whether you attended elementary school at FM, IC, or another part of the country, I hope it brought you back to your time in elementary school. As you walked through the halls, did you notice their faces? Their wide eyes, grins from ear to ear. Some were jumping with excitement. The kids were too. Cheering, slapping high fives, they were so excited to welcome you back to their world. A world that provided so many of you with, I hope, lots of fond memories. I want you to think back to that time. Imagine yourself sitting in those little desks. Do you remember? Can you see yourself? You learned so much in those first few years of formal education, lessons that transcend time and are just as important now as they are in the future. It's really one of my favorite traditions that we started just a few years ago. Again, not only for you, but also for all those students in those elementary schools and the staff. The high school staff that gets to accompany the students each year truly love that experience. I love walking through those halls with you. It was different for me Wednesday. You see, as I turned the corner with you, walking down Enders Road, that final turn to head out, I saw my youngest child, Wyatt. He's in fourth grade. So happy. He was bouncing up and down, so excited, each one of you. Everything just seemed to slow down for a moment. I watched him giving many of you high fives, cheering you on. It felt just like yesterday that my wife and I had waved goodbye as he stepped foot on a bus to go to kindergarten. And I guarantee you, your parents have thought the exact same thing. For a few short moments, I just stopped and replayed so many of the fond memories of his young life, wondering where the time went in disbelief that our youngest was about to be done with elementary school. Life comes at us so fast. Doesn't it seem like yesterday that you were there? Doesn't it seem like yesterday you were just walking in freshman year? Days and weeks, months pass by in a flash. Life seems to be flying by at breakneck speed. Or maybe it's not that life's moving faster, but that we're moving faster and faster through life. Doesn't it feel like we're busier and busier? Maybe busier than we've ever been? Responsibilities, expectations seem greater and greater. There's more and more. Those opportunities where you can catch your breath seem like they're getting smaller and fewer. Why does it take significant moments like these to get us all to just stop and take notice? Why do we need reminders to stop and appreciate all the wonderful gifts that we have in our lives? I wish I could stand here in front of you and tell you it gets easier. It doesn't. It doesn't get easier to slow down. It doesn't get easier to take time to appreciate each day. I know there's going to be stuff to do always. There's always going to be a new demand to be met. But what I hope is I hope that you'll feel empowered to maintain control of your life, because it is yours and you are in control. So a couple of things as you move on. First, this is your life. You decide how you're going to perceive this world. You decide how you will respond to the gifts you receive and the challenges you face. These gifts and challenges help us to define our place in our world. Will you work to better yourself and those around you? Will you embrace each experience life throws at you? Or are you going to be a passive victim of circumstance? That's up to you. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your voice. Having a strong sense of self, embracing your values, will always allow you to move comfortable, feel comfortable with yourself and the decisions you make. Two, have a positive impact on others. Just as others have an impact on the trajectory of your story, you have an impact on theirs. You decide whether you will work to make those interactions positive. Living in a world where we focus on caring for one another instead of placing judgment is a world we'll all find greater happiness in. Be kind. Just like Mrs. Halloran said, being kind is not effortless. You must demonstrate honesty, sincerity, while forming genuine connections and relationships with others. Smile. You're in control of your attitude. Each day is full of endless possibilities. Be present to see them. When you walk down the street, don't stare into the ground or your phone. Look people in the eye and smile. You'll be surprised how many people will return. You don't know everything. You probably never will. Don't walk through life thinking you have all the answers. The smartest people I know spend more time asking questions than announcing answers. Spend your life seeking to understand. Live in the present. Don't be overwhelmed by the thought of the future, nor weighed down by the past. Take time to enjoy every step of that path. Take you back to Tuesday, 8th period, auditorium. I was struck as I watched all of you sitting together, watching the senior slideshow and the video together. Afternoon announcements came on, you sat there. The bell rang, students are leaving, you sat there. Together, enjoying the moment together. Take time to enjoy all the moments of your life. You deserve that. And to repeat what I think we've heard every speaker talk about today, place your family first. No matter where you go, remember, always keep close to you your family and friends, for those are your greatest resource and supporters in good times and in bad. You're here today partly because of the support your family and friends have provided along the way. In the end, I hope you'll look back at your time as an FM student and be proud of yourself. I, for one, know your school district and I am so proud of each of you. Congratulations, class of 2023. It's that time. So, Dr. Karen Liparulo, Mr. Patrick McNamara, Ms. Mary Ann Murphy, Assistant Principal, Ms. Heidi Green, Director of Counseling Services, Dr. Craig Tice, Board of Education members, Vice President Sharon Lindars, Mr. Jason Catalino, Ms. Sarah Fitzgerald, Mr. Dan Seidberg, and Ms. Daryl Fitch-Wheeler will be assisting in the presentation of diplomas this evening. At this time, I ask students in Section A to come forward.
There is. I don't know if you want this.
Uh-huh.
But if you want to do that.
Is it on? It's on already. It's not on yet, right? Is it on?
Yes.
George Abdulki. Ebunalua Phoebe Abalade. Isabella Jolie Adrian. Anthony G1 An. Seth Aaron Albert. Monir Alboom. Rachel Joelle Alpert. Ruby Ellen Amack. Habib Amiri. John Pippins Angela Cola. Joseph Charles Antonacci. Jack Benjamin Anschel. Sarah Lynn Bailey. Talbot Ferris Baldwin. Jean Gregory Ballion. Connor Lawrence Ball. Kirk Callagher Baines. Stella Addison Barlow. Samantha Marie Barton. Ethan Henry Baddock. Christopher Allen Benedicto. Christian James Benz. Julia Ann Bertelsmann. Brian Corey Bird. Caden Quinn Blazina. Ryan Matthew Blum. Amara Emily Blythe. Grace Elizabeth Boyce. Omar Bura Buaram. Cassandra Noel Boyko. Catherine Colligan Brady. Anthony David Brennick. Angela Maria Brito Suarez. Liam Gregory Brown. Madison Ainsley Brown. Lincoln Gray Bulow. Noah Robert Cadwell. Avery Lee Caldwell. Paul David Kanji. Cecilia Chow. Evangelos Caritas Cappers. Owen Alexander Capria. Alexa Lee Karen. Tomlin Haley Kerrigan. Victoria Cavallini.
Christopher Michael Chack. Meher Kaur Chahal. Grover Perrin H.H. Chowning. May Cohen. Emmanuel Adarius Coleman. Sarah Rose Coleman. Kirsten Rose Comer. Julia Claire Comprey. David Joseph Concannon. Thomas John Conley. Margaret Mary Crisafulli. Dylan Cooper Chrysler. Maya Julissa Pudrado. Alex James Daly. Maxwell Liam Danaher. Oksana Maria Dannenberg. Stuart McDonald Davies. Timothy William DeLands. Annabella Cecilia Dentler. Cooper J. Darashinsky. Luciano DeRoberts. Thomas Joseph Diana. Nathaniel Douglas Dimmitt. Chloe Alexandra Dion. Tyler Holland Dixie. Jack Monroe Dixon. Caleb George Doan. Nicholas Patrick Donnelly. Kira Nicole Dumas. Samuel Fitzgerald Duncanson. Michael William Dutch. Tristan Michael Endress. Samantha Rose Estock. Giovanni Salvatore Failla. Lance Hansen Featherstone. Mary Helen Feck. Mary Claire Felix. Ella Noelle Fesco. Benedita Appleton Figuera. Elizabeth Grace Fiske. Anna Torres Fontaine. Amy Jo Fosick. Riley Carmela Frederick. Jacob James Friedank. Jace Troyel Frizzicano.
Giselle Joynine Fumarola. Hind Abu Elgasam Gadam. Macy J. Gallagher. Lucy Lee Ming Gamble. Davy Jacob George. Luciano Edward Gibson. DeWitt Dejir Gibson Rhoda Fox. Armon Goyle. Connor David Gepfert. Tyler Michael Goodman. Julia Rose Gorman. James Denny Grace. Sydney Ann Green. Taylor Elizabeth Green. Xavier Anthony Alfred Green. Marcella Ruth Gully Grubka. Colin William Gunderson. Sam Dylan Gwynn. Denham Akeem Hall. Kaylee May Hamilton. Michael John Hance. Lena Shay Hansen. Per Sophia Isis Harbor. Liam Edward Hartnett Ware. Jane Ellen Harwood. Ahmad Hassan. Troy Juyuan He. Timothy Connor Heaton. Emerson Ryan Heimbach. John Robert Henderson. Ella Rose Herber. Austin Michael Higgins. Scott Ebert Hills. Sydney Grace Hines. Lauren Riley Hoffman. Sammy Mahadeen Hossein. Tyler Henry Hutchison. Kyle Daniel Iancello. Carmen Julia Iorio. Hassan Irfan. Alana Rose Isley. Charlene Zara James. Ava Coleman Jeffers. Valerie Mae Jernigan.
Sivan Juran. Parker Ronald Kazarowski. Hannah Claire Kircher. Henry Ward Kaiser. Ian David Kampf. Sarah M. Karimi. Evelyn Grace Kawa. Daniel Michael Kenny. Kalata Katoon. Anna Linson Kiefer. Olivia Margaret Kimbrough. Madison Rose Kirkpatrick. Michaela Lynn Neer. Matthew Jacob Neer. Eric Tony Kushnicharsky. Adam Michael Koss. Isabel Grace Coster. Sean Luen Kraus. Brendan Michael Robert Kraus. Ella Catherine Chrisman. Sarah Elizabeth Cronenberg. Sanji Kumar. Alexis Marie Cuss. Samuel Joseph Cuss. George Daniel Lacombe. Madison Jolie Lefex. Jack David Lamberton. Brooke Ann Lampfear. Clara Jean Leek. Julia Leary. Aiden Isaac Lee. Claire Yujung Lee. Joshua Isaac Lefkowitz. Ann Campbell Leonard. Sophia Vincenza Leonard. Elvis Lee. Darren Lynn. John Brett Linhart. Gabriella Elizabeth Link. Claire Liu. Vicky Liu. Charles Thomas Lorraine. Clara Ann McCreary. Robert Michael Madden.
Liam Peter Malgeri. Madeline Elizabeth Malgeri. Christina Lee Antoinette Martin. Christopher Dwayne Strone Martin. Alexander Richard Martinez. Natalie Alyssa Main. Mara Catherine McBride. Kevin Patrick McKnight. Molly Virginia McNanny. Griffin Martin McRae. Lucia Nicola Melfi. Grace Emma Metnick. Colin Joseph Meyer. Kalem Jimin Michael. Alora Dannon Miller. Mason Theodore Miller. Jacob Peter Mohammed. Cameron James Moore. Miles Anthony Moore. Juliana Amon Musa. Brandon Robert Murphy. Vignesh Murgisan. Zoe Danielle Mint. Tyler Etridge Nathan. Nadav David Nesher. Luke Daniel Nestor. Evan Selvakumar Newton. Larissa Marie Nichols. Kayleen Elise Noble. Emily Ann Knoll. Tara Elizabeth Nugent. Carly Elizabeth O'Connor. Gwendolyn Elizabeth O'Connor. Emma Obradovich. Chirag Ori. Dylan Scott Olson. Anthony Jude Otis. Kelvin Uyang. Avery Grace Page. Carter Jamison Page. Natala Ruby Grace Palladino. Hannah Park. Nikolai Alexander Pavlov. Maya Dina Pereira.
Benjamin Lonergan Perry. Georgia Marie Perry. Nicholas Paul Petosa. Alexandra Marie Flans. Cody Tyler Pinsky. Emily Susan Pollard. Jacqueline Lily Pollock. Lila Catherine Poole. Sarah Hallinan Porter. Frederick James Price. Stephen David Probst. Gwendolyn Elizabeth Prue. Alexander Joseph Purcell. Katia Mia Quinn. Benjamin Thomas Rabin. Nicholas Robert Ranieri. Jane DeCourcy Raven. Isabella Noelle Raymond. Samuel John Rasmaju. Philip Ethan Rikus. Honora Jean Reisner. Ainsley Gael Resig. Grace Donahue Reyna. Nicholas Armand Ricardello. Amanda Castelnova Richardson. Sara Malaika Rinzan. Trevor Robert Rowe. Garrett Anton Rogers. Owen Michael Rohan. Jonah Alexander Rude Creel. Matthew Elijah Rowe. Lucia Rueda Borgatti. Jonah Steven Ruthig. Emily June Ryan. Shrujamia Sympathy. Ashley Catherine Schneider. Deacon Joseph Scroggins II. Anna Christine Saraluca. Selena Claire Grace Choiquette. Karina Nicole Silvis. Caden Joseph Sisko. Kareen Lena Smith. Zachary Crandall Spencer. Antonina Dominica Spinello.
Aitan Spinoza. Daniel John Stark. Wyatt Cole Steele. Sarai Cora Stenson. Ash Cleveland Stock. Dylan Brian Stone. Riley Michael Patrick Strindberg. Julia Raylene Sun. Michael Scott Surowick. Noah Colvin Sweet. Carly Michael Sweetman. Ruthie Jane Tabor. Monique Sophia Tadeau. Ethan Henry Turkowitz. Thomas Jeffrey Trishiani. Gavin Reed Trussell. Abraham Urencio. Jamie Grace Utter. Trevor David Valletta. Grace Louise Vandewater. Jack McCabe Vredenberg. Hallie Patricia Constance Wadsworth. Nathan Andrew Walls. Sebastian Thomas Warner. Zen Jeffrey Warner. Brandon Logan Warren. Mason DeFlorio Wires. Luke Richard Wiziger. Colin Edward Welder. Kayan Michael White. Margaret Kathleen White. Zachary Thomas Wiedemann. Anthony Vincent Wigan. Hannah Rose Williamson. Allison Wong. Mason Eugene Wright. Alex Wu. Kevin Wang Wu. Lan Xin Shao. Yulia Maldaikite Yaski. Ryan James Yenny. Anna Sagrodny. Marissa Zhai. Yuhan Chu. Annalisa Zizzo.
So this time, class of 2023, would you please rise? Victoria Cavallini, would you come forward? It is with great pleasure that I declare you to be graduates of Fayetteville Manlius High School. All right, class of 2023, as is tradition, we always end graduation with the singing of the alma mater. Just in case you don't have the words, they're on the program, even though you should know the words by now. I'm gonna get you started, but I expect you to take over. Everyone ready? All right. Guarded by congratulations, class of 2023. We are so proud of you. Thank you all for coming. Again, congratulations, class of 2023.